two of his last three matches. Has the captain, Sean Dean. Yeah, he's set to go one-on-one.
Come on now.
CM Punk and MJF running from Punk.
Like a scalded dog, he's running.
MJF can't have it both ways. You can't call down CM Punk without having to face that man. CM Punk. Oh, wait,
what the hell?
CM Punk.
Oh, the GTS on Sean Dean.
That's a little surprising.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of this match as a result of a disqualification, Captain Sean Dean.
Oh, MJF! He just got a
loss! Are you kidding me? Are you freaking kidding me?
Yeah, the record's reset in the new year.
Yeah, you're 0-1. Captain 20-0. He's got a losing record. What a win for the captain. This is tremendous.
This is your future. This happens every single time you step into the ring until you step in the ring with me, you little bitch.
Okay, it's bad enough. I am currently inside this cesspool known as herpes-infested New Jersey.
Hey, don't harp on them. They're winners. You just lost. It's gonna be real hard to fight for a title when you keep losing.
Okay, you wanna talk about being a loser? Everything that comes out of your mouth is fake. Everything that comes out of your mouth is fake and induces boredom. The only thing... No. You came out here last week and you said you were done with this. You said you wanted to focus on becoming a world champion. And now look at you. Where are you? Right back where you started. You want to know why? You might have these schmucks convinced you're a big deal, but I know the truth. And the truth is, deep down you know without me, you're nothing. I give you an edge. I put a chip on your shoulder. I make you relevant.
I can call bullshit on that. Fans around the world can.
And for you to come out here and claim that I'm a waste of money, when you're the guy that sold Tony Khan and all of these people nothing more than a bill of goods. You ain't the guy you used to be, Punk. You ain't the savior these people have been waiting for. But you know who is? Maxwell Jacob Friedman. And by the way, I think it's really interesting. You have such a problem with me saying I'm like Roddy Piper. You really got offended when I drummed up that comparison. So I'm just curious, PG Punk, do you think... Do you think you're Roddy Piper? Because the last time I checked, unlike you, Piper was actually talented enough to main event a WrestleMania. So maybe shut up? I don't know. And by the way, if I'm not starting to be shown the proper respect around here, maybe I'll main event a Mania 2.
God, he sucks.
What are you laughing at, dipshit?
All I'm trying to do is kick your ass, so how about you stop talking and get in the ring? I'll do it right here, right now in New Jersey. You ran from me. You hid behind FTR. All I want to do is give you the beating you deserve. And listen, pal, if you think the grass is so greener on the other side, be my guest. Go ahead, leave. Main event night 4 of a buy one, get one free extravaganza, and then get released faster than you last in the sack. When you come back, I'll still be here, and that ass kicking will be waiting for you.
Is that right? Yeah? You want a piece of me, Punk? You want the match? You people want the match? You want the goddamn match? Well, listen here, you son of a bitch! Next week, it's gonna be CM Punk!
Say it.
Versus Wardlow!
Spineless till the end.
I don't need it. I'm better than you. I'm better than you. I don't need your help, fat boy. I don't need your help.
The difference between myself, Roddy Piper, and a worm like you is me and Piper would fight anybody, anytime. So bring on Wardlow. Eventually, you're gonna run out of people to hide behind, and I'm gonna put you to sleep.
Well, there you hear it, fellas.
Man, spineless coward. I'm running out of adjectives here.
Yeah, but what a great match it would be next week. Wardlow, man. And CM Punk.
Wait, right now, CM Punk is dead weight.
Wardlow
looks disgusted.
Voice up CM Punk and the powerbomb through the table.
Got it. CM Punk is getting dismantled. Disjointed.
All right, that's it.
Assaulted.
Man. Oh, smirk on that coward's face.
Look at this carnage.
You can hear the carnage, see the carnage, and CM Punk is damn sure feel the carnage.
And CM Punk, you know there's not an ounce of quit in his heart.
And he may be counted out here. Remember, a week ago, MJF was counted out.
Yeah, Dr. Samson really got to intervene here, I think, to make sure that Punk can defend himself to some degree.
My God, look at him push himself up.
Punk trying valiantly, but can he beat the count?
Crawling, go get him. Fix yourself.
The referee's been very kind on her count.
And this crowd urging Punk on. Can Punk make it?
Nine, her second away here.
Oh.
Man, Aubrey Evers, she didn't pull the string.
No, I'm glad she did. I'm glad she did. And man, what perseverance, what determination.
JF calling all the plays here. Another powerbomb on deck for CM Punk. And
he can't even get to his feet. CM Punk. This is where Audrey's got to sit.
Oh, wait a second. Punk is a cradle. 2, 3.
Wardlow never saw that one coming.
The winner of this match, CM Punk.
CM Punk raised his record to 10-0.
Spears. Okay. Well, I beat FTR. I beat Wardlow. Now I have to beat Sean Spears. And at the end of this rainbow, the pot of gold's MJF. Apparently, he's gonna throw every single body he can in front of himself in my way before I get to him. I'm gonna get to him. This ends when me and you earn a ring, MJF. If I gotta go through Spears, well, I just went through Wardlow. You think I'm afraid of Sean Spears? Fight anybody, anywhere, anytime. You're running out of bodies. You're running out of luck. And before you know it, you're gonna wind up having to get in the ring with me, possibly in the place you least want to fight, CM Punk.
damn fight here.
And his opponent, carrying him down the aisle, from Chicago, Illinois, weighing 218 pounds, CM Punk.
A understatement. Are we one step closer to CM Punk and MJF, or are we near the end where MJF has escaped?
And a reminder to fans in the greater Fort Myers area that you can join us for AEW's debut at the Hertz Arena on Wednesday, March 9th, for the fallout of Revolution. Tickets go on sale this Friday, and then AEW will be making our San Antonio debut on Wednesday, March 13th, at the historic Freeman Coliseum, and then we'll be returning to the Austin area, the HEB Center in Cedar Park on March 23rd. Tickets for those events go on sale Friday, January 28th, AEWTIX.com and Ticketmaster.com.
And you know, in San Antonio, that's the old arena.
Yeah, the old
arena. All that history.
Yeah. Absolutely.
One thing about AEW, JR, is we don't run away from history.
Sure don't.
Yeah, we're living proof of that.
Can't hide from it. Embrace it. Respect it.
And speaking of running away, I hope MJF will run in the opposite direction from the booth.
He's coming to the commentary, right? Well, it is the season for powder blue.
It is?
I don't know. I don't know. I don't care what he wears.
Whatever color, he doesn't wear it well.
MJF first through FTR in the path of CM Punk, then Wardlow.
Excalibur, shut up. This is going to be awesome. Right now, the chairman, Sean Spears, greatest accountability buddy of all time, about to hand PG Punk his first loss.
He's trying to get your attention there, Max.
Whoa, wait a second, Punk.
Whoa,
yeah, he's got
right
Spears.
Now.
Oh, my God.
That's got to be it. Hold on, kick.
For MJF.
The Punk says, come on here, get in the ring.
Punk didn't even break a sweat. And he is primed to put MJF to sleep.
Through the eyes of CM Punk, the intensity. I'm liking what I'm seeing here, fellas. When they meet, turn to God, they will meet in our lifetime. It's gonna be epic.
Oh, wait a second, MJF like a snake in the grass. Creeping up behind.
He knew he was there. He knew he was there, he wanted him in the ring.
And now CM Punk's got MJF right where he wants him. Oh.
Not the scar. That'd be worse than a dipping dots, for God's sakes.
Whoa, MJF bailing out once again.
Talk about running like a scalded dog. The young gentleman from Long Island got the hell out of the ring here.
And CM Punk walking out of D.C. with a trophy.
Yeah.
But that's not what he wants, Tony. Championship Friday on Rampage. But before that, we will hear from the best in the world.
Undoubtedly, the best in the world, CM Punk, who has a red hot issue with MJF.
And look at this, Punk is dressed to fight.
I think Punk's patience as it relates to MJF are thinning.
Remember, next Wednesday night, AEW will be in CM Punk's hometown of Chicago, Illinois at the Wintrust Arena. And then we'll be making our Atlantic City debut on Wednesday, February 9th at the historic Boardwalk Hall. Tickets for both events on sale right now, AEWTIX.com and Ticketmaster.com. CM Punk ready for war here tonight.
Nobody more popular in AEW than CM Punk.
And I know he wants to fight MJF sooner than later, and tonight would be just fine.
Damn right it'd be just fine. Just hit him in the mouth one time for me. One time for every fan who is tired of listening to the bile that spews out of the mouth of MJF.
Yes, MJF, the inverse of CM Punk. There's nobody more despised or reviled here than Maxwell Jacob Friedman.
Very rare you see an athlete come along that can captivate an audience with a couple of notes of his entrance music. And that's what we've got here.
Hello, Cleveland. How's everybody doing tonight? Man, I tried to walk out here like a badass, and you guys just make me smile from ear to ear. It's been a minute. It's been a minute since I've been here, but are you sick of hearing me talk yet? No, see? You got it wrong, Cleveland. I'm sick of hearing me talk. That's why I'm dressed to fight. I got the long boys on. I'm taped up. This is dynamite. This is live. Y'all know who I want to fight? Go ahead, chant his name. It'll be the first time in history. Let's go.
Sucks. Sucks. Sorry.
Don't apologize, Tony.
Okay, buddy.
First and last time that name will get chanted. And look, from last week, I got myself a little bit of a souvenir.
Stylish.
Looks good on him. Really frames his face.
That's one of his highlights of his life, framing his
face. No, it does not look good on me. It doesn't look good on anybody. I thought for a heartbeat as I snatched this while it was still around his pencil little neck that maybe, just maybe, I could maybe, I don't know, challenge him to a match, see if he really wanted this back. I thought maybe this was sentimental to him. And then I used Google and I saw that for $5, you get a 12-pack on Amazon. It's just as cheap as his personality. I looked further at the price tag on this thing, and it said made in Long Island. So I immediately knew it was not made of strong material. Because I'm sick of just talking about it. I'm sick of hearing him talk. What I need is MJF in this ring. And I thought maybe, Cleveland, I owed you one, so I thought, what the hell? Let's do it tonight! I'm realistic, though, and I can only imagine if I call him out, he's gonna come out here in a cheap suit that doesn't fit him, and he's gonna have every excuse in the world. And I've chased him out of the ring, up the concourse, down the steps, back into the ring. I've gone through FTR, Wardlow, Sean Spears, everybody. There's nobody left. I want MJF, and I want him now, and I want him right here in Cleveland.
Well, maybe business is about to pick up.
I would hope so. But I'm sure he's going to keep his distance.
MJF not appear to be dressed.
Cut my music! Cut my music!
Cut his crappy music! Cut his crappy music!
Hey, they're chanting what you were thinking, Tony.
Yeah, I was a little bit ahead of my time here.
Oh, I suck, Cleveland?
Yes, you do.
So you're saying you don't want to see me wrestle him tonight? Is that what you're saying? Oh, so you want to see us wrestle tonight? So you want me to go backstage, change into my gear, and wrestle him tonight in an impromptu main event? Is that what you want? Cleveland, I know you're dumb, but I didn't know you were deaf. I asked you a question. Do you want to see us wrestle right here, right now? No. Are you guys out of your mind? Do you think I would waste one of the most historical matchups in the history of this sport on Cleveland, Ohio? This place is disgusting. This place is an absolute cesspool. No, 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 but I'll tell you what, I'll tell you what, I'll do you one better. I'll do you one better. I'll give you the match you've all been waiting for next week in Chicago, Illinois.
What?
It will be CM Punk versus MJF. But we ain't in Chicago right now, are we? No, 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 we are in crappy Cleveland. A disgusting place, but a place rich in historical significance in the timeline of that gentleman's career, but we'll get to that. You know, this match, it's a dream match. It's something these people have grown impatient to see. They want the match right now. These people are frothing at the mouth for CM Punk versus MJF. They want it. Or at least they think they do. Because while the match itself is going to be spectacular, it is the outcome that is going to be very upsetting. See, not only am I going to beat you in that dumpster fire you call a hometown known as Chicago.
Do it here, bitch. Do it here.
Nah. No. I'll be beating you in the Midwest. But it ain't going to be here. No, it's going to be in Chicago. And after I beat you, something very unsettling is going to happen. After I win, you people are finally going to get to see the real CM Punk. The CM Punk who loses his fake smile the second he doesn't get what he wants. The CM Punk who blames all of his failures on everyone else but himself. The CM Punk who, if he feels like he hasn't gotten his just due, he's more than willing to sue. Your same hero who claimed on his almighty return August 13th, 2005, I left professional wrestling August 20th, 2021, I'm back, will soon say on February 2nd, I'm leaving wrestling again. Oh, MJF, he would never leave us again. He loves us. Didn't you guys say the same thing about LeBron James? I'm just curious. Last time I checked, though, it was a slap in the face when he claimed that he left in 2005, because that ain't the truth. Truth is, he left all of you, and he left all the fans who loved him and supported him when he was scheduled to make an appearance right here in Cleveland, Ohio, back in 2014. But he no-showed, and he turned his back on each and every one of you. What makes you think he won't do it again? And you watching at home on the silver screen, yeah, I'm talking to you. You think he gives a damn that you spent the last 7 years chanting his name at the top of your lungs? Yeah. Yeah. I got news for you. All those chants aren't going to stop him from turning his back on you again and then crying about it on a podcast.
A podcast that you listen to because you're a fan. The next two things I say are not mutually exclusive. The best thing I ever did was leave. The best thing I ever did was come back. And if I didn't come back, well, you wouldn't have your brush with greatness that you're currently having, would you, Max? Go in the back, lace up your 3-inch lifts with your boots, and get in the ring and handle business. We know you can't. You know you can't. I know you can't. And Cleveland knows you can't. Poor little Maxwell, sitting at home watching his hero on television, too prepubescent to realize the athletes he admires on television are human beings. Sometimes you gotta take matters into your own hands, and that's what I've always done. I've never lied to the people. Some of them love me. Some of them hate me. That's what life is. But I would rather be me, and I would rather try and fail than be you and talk a big game and never show up. You pay to see me. You pay to stand in line to get my picture. You stand in line to get my autograph, and how dare you try to put it on these people? I've made decisions. I stand by every single one of them. And these people, they don't love me because I win. They don't hate me because I lose. They love me because I get back up and I try and I fight, just like Cleveland does. Just like Chicago does.
Oh, you always get back up, huh?
Yeah, I always get back up.
Oh, okay. How about we test that real quick?
All right. MJF bringing the backup. Of course he is.
Dax Harwood, Cash Wheeler, and Wardlow.
Always get back up, do you?
Oh, wait, Sean Spears from behind.
The chairman coming from behind, a typical MJF-led scenario.
Yeah, the pinnacle.
It's a 3-on-1 assault right now, and Wardlow inside the ring.
They're going to soften him up for that symphony, I bet.
They could be trying to take Punk out of next week. MJF just trying to get further and further away from CM Punk.
Well, you knew when MJF said, "I'll wrestle you next week in Chicago," that he had some sort of devious plan.
Oh, this is bad. This is really bad.
Oh, that's steel across the spine of CM Punk, which just weeks ago, Wardlow powerbombed 8 consecutive times.
Notice Wardlow's involvement in this scenario is somewhat docile.
It's kind of a non-involvement, really.
Correct.
How about you get up now, Punk, huh? Huh? How about you get up now, you dumb son of a bitch!
Well, CM Punk not backing down. Oh, but the right hand.
Get up! Get up! Get up! Hey! Powerbomb. Powerbomb.
I told you I could see this coming, man. They were just setting him up to powerbombing.
You got 3 other guys in the ring. Can they not powerbomb somebody? Come on.
Nobody has quite the destructive force of Wardlow.
Of course not.
Gonna powerbomb.
You got 3 guys there, Excalibur, for God's sakes.
Gonna powerbomb him on a damn chair.
MJF with a big grin on his face. Wardlow. Powerbomb!
Flying first on that steel chair lying in the middle of the ring. 7 days before these two men fight in Chicago next Wednesday night.
Oh, come on.
That's cool. That's really cool right there.
This is...
That's it right there,
man. It's revolting.
It is so apropos that the same place your journey started will be the same place it ends. I'll see you in Chicago!
And if you need another reason to join us live next week, there it is.
But what shape will CM Punk be in?
Nothing to say about that statement. You beat his ass, you might shut him up. But thus far, that hasn't happened very often.
Hey, Maxwell.
I shut up the great MJF without saying a word.
You really hurt my feelings last week. I extended out my hand like a gentleman. You didn't want to go toe-to-toe with me on the stick, Punk? Well, too bad, because I'm about to verbally finish you quicker than your UFC career.
The lowest hanging fruit.
You can drop cute little pipe bombs all you want, because I'm MJF, and I drop nukes. You, my friend, are no more than nostalgia.
You talk too much. Yeah, just like me back in the day, except I always backed it up, and you can't back up shit without your backup.
You've struggled to beat the easiest of competition.
I've gone through FTR.
Deep down, you know it.
Wardlow, Shawn Spears.
These people know it.
Everybody, there's nobody left.
Your whole career, you've been nothing more than second best.
They call Chicago the second city, not because there's a city that's better than it.
You may claim to be the best in the world.
They call us the second city because when it burned to the ground, we just built right back up on top of the smoldering embers.
But I'm better than you, and you know it.
I'll give you the match you've all been waiting for next week. In Chicago, Illinois, it will be CM Punk versus MJF!
Something very unsettling is going to happen. After I win, you people are finally going to get to see the real CM Punk.
I understand if MJF is afraid.
The CM Punk who loses his fake smile.
If MJF is scared.
The second he doesn't get what he wants.
Nobody can touch me.
The CM Punk who blames all of his failures on everyone else but himself. Your same hero who claimed on his almighty return August 13th, 2005, I left professional wrestling August 20th, 2021. I'm back. We'll soon say on February 2nd, I'm leaving wrestling again. He left all of you, and he left all the fans who loved him, and he turned his back on each and every one of you.
Best thing I ever did was leave. The best thing I ever did was come back.
You think he gives a damn that you spent the last 7 years chanting his name?
And if I didn't come back, well, you wouldn't have your brush with greatness that you're currently having, would you, Max?
All those chants aren't gonna stop him from turning his back on you again?
Sometimes you gotta take matters into your own hands, and that's what I've always done. I've never lied to the people. I've made decisions. I stand by every single one of them. They don't love me because I win. They don't hate me because I lose. They love me because I get back up and I try and I fight just like Chicago does.
CM Punk has arrived in All Elite Wrestling.
It is so apropos that the same place your journey started will be the same place it ends.
On Dynamite! Let's get it on! Shimon, are you ready?
Damn right!
One of the fun parts of this job, there are many aspects.
Coming down the aisle from Chicago!
Legitimate hometown hero. Finally getting the match he's been waiting on. MJF, CM Punk, quite frankly, fellas, I know the three of us have been waiting on it as well.
I'll tell you, much different demeanor on the face and the approach here for CM Punk than it was back when he made his debut in August in this city on Rampage. A lot of smiles back then, Excalibur, but a serious look now.
Yeah, CM Punk coming to the ring with a set jaw. He knows that for all of MJF's talk, his bravado, that MJF underneath it all, an exceptionally talented professional wrestler. And after that beating that CM Punk received last Wednesday night at the hand of MJF in the Pinnacle. You have to imagine that.
He told me earlier today, as counter on that topic, he's there to see him about his soul. He feels like he's been in the battle already after last week. But he wasn't bitching and moaning, not making any excuses.
There's never any excuses with CM Punk.
No, well, there should be. Hard veteran.
Now what a big time feel to this main event. That's the building and building. He's had to face Wardlow. He's had to face Sean Spears.
Biggest match ever, I think, Tony, for MJF. He's only been in the business 6 years. I can't imagine him being in a bigger match, emotionally bigger, than the one he's about to begin here.
Nothing pretty about it. It was just effective.
He took advantage.
Oh my God.
Of the scenario, and now the momentum's changed.
Covered by MJF. We saw in picture in picture MJF locking the left elbow of CM Punk, using that as a fulcrum to take Punk over the top with the suplex, and then doing it off the ropes there.
Wow. Right back to the arm again.
That's smart. That's just real smart wrestling.
Punk anticipated. Oh! And a Pepsi twist from CM Punk.
Remember, that right arm is healthy, as you can see. This crowd loves this guy. He's earned it. Indies. Wrestling before 200 or 300 people. Developing his chops in this Chicagoland area.
Oh, look at this coward. MJF pulling the referee in front of him.
What's he doing? What's he got in his hands?
Oh, MJF!
Is that tape? Is that tape from his wrist?
He's got something, and he's...
He doesn't have anything stuck in his throat, ref. He's being choked, for God's sakes.
But the referee can't see it. It's underneath MJF's arm.
Fans trying to tell Bryce Remsburg there's something going on there.
There is. He puts his hands under there and checks. That's what he does.
Look at this, Punk is fading.
Are you kidding me?
MJF. Oh, wait a second.
Wow, what reserve.
But Punk, right back.
It's the tape, man. The tape just drove him back down.
And CM Punk with nowhere left to go. MJF with the body scissors locked in.
He may go out
right
here.
Come on, not like this. Not like that. Oh.
How humiliating would it be for CM Punk to lose in his hometown by submission or match stoppage?
They can chant all they want, but you can see the eyes. Hey, he's going out, guys.
MJF, there's one.
Oh, my God.
No, come on. Punk
That's it. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me?
MJF.
MJF.
It cannot end that way. No, there's no.
Just choked out CM Punk. He used that garrote and he choked out CM Punk. Wait a second.
What was that?
Bryce Rensburg sees the tape. It was apparent to everyone.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Referee Bryce Rensburg has ruled this match will continue.
The right thing to do.
Dished out by MJF.
MJF got Punk up. He's looking for perhaps a tombstone pile driver. Punk. Punk trying to reverse it.
All about the leverage.
Got it.
The leverage.
With one arm and one leg, but oh. MJF reverses. Two. No.
The reverse is what it was, but. Oh. That was what it was, too. That may be the winner right there.
The roundhouse kick drops MJF. If Punk can make this climb, he can end it right now.
He's willing himself to the top.
MJF in trouble as CM Punk.
Taking a big chance, all or nothing here for CM Punk in his hometown.
Drops the elbow. One, two. Oh, no.
Very last moment. Couldn't get any closer than that one. Punk kind of bewildered that he didn't get MJF on that exchange.
Man, I'm telling you, I'm not in the ring, but I'm spent. Spent.
That has got to be frustrating, even deflating for CM Punk, but he can't allow that to affect his mindset. Punk willing himself up to his feet, drawing on the energy from Chicago.
I've been told we're going to stay with this match for as long as it takes. So hang with us here on TBS. We've seen great matches. This is kind of a defining match in AEW.
Oh.
Oh, God.
Wardlow. Now, this is most interesting because I don't know exactly where Wardlow's allegiance lies.
Well, listen, I knew the pinnacle was around.
But I'm not so sure that Wardlow is representing the pinnacle.
Well, Wardlow does have that contract with MJF.
That's the defining part right there.
And he looks conflicted.
It really puts a pressure on the referee.
Interesting. He's slowly.
We saw how slow to act Wardlow was last week, and now.
Uh-oh.
Getting eye to eye with CM Punk.
I don't like this. This is a little iffy to me.
Yeah, this is not good. Wait. He walked away. And on one leg, on one damn leg, he's going after him again.
Punk looking over his shoulder.
Yeah, well,
he doesn't trust Wardlow either.
Well, he just kind of stepped out of the way there.
Well, Wardlow.
Look out behind.
Think about this.
MJF! Was that the ring?
The right hand with the ring!
He
stuffed it in his trunks.
Right between the eyes.
And now, MJF covers.
No.
Come on!
CM Punk loses to MJF. What a match, ladies and gentlemen. We've all been privileged to witness.
You gotta be kidding me. Gotta be kidding me. Look at this. This is great. I gotta go talk to this guy. He shut him up, thank God.
Gosh, you know, I'm watching the monitor in the back, and you're talking about beating me in Chicago. Your win in Chicago is about as suspect as your spray tan. I'm a little bit of an island amongst myself. I don't like to ask for help. Luckily, today, I've learned from my mistake a couple of weeks ago. You bunch of jackasses like to pick your spots and beat up one guy. Today, I got some friends.
Darby Allin and Sting here.
Sting!
And they brought the lumber.
Take your jackets off, get your dress shoes off. This is gonna go one of two ways. I'm either gonna get what I want, or I'm gonna come down here with my friends and I'm gonna beat it out of you. I want a rematch.
Whoa. I just beat you twice. You don't deserve
Max,
a rematch.
Max, I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to the guy that beat me in Chicago, Wardlow. Because let's face it, the whole lot of you in the ring wouldn't have won anything in the last 6 months if it wasn't for that man. And big man, listen to me good. You can be on the end of the beating these guys are about to receive, or you can grow some balls and you can leave these jerks.
Okay, hold on, big man, hold on. First of all, I beat you all by myself in Chicago.
Oh, really?
You all know it.
You hear him, Wardlow? You hear him?
Hold on, and second of all, Wardlow hangs around us, not just because he's under contract with me, but because he's our best friend. Everybody knows that.
Just shut up, Max. Give me a rematch.
And third of all,
give me a rematch.
Punk, do you think I enjoy dressing like this, huh? Hell no, I don't even look good in a damn suit. But here's the thing, I am comfortable in my fighting attire, and you talking about rematches, well, you got the absolute best tag team in this damn world in the ring, and I'm begging for a rematch.
All you had to do was ask, Dax. Sign me up. The three of us, we want a rematch from Greensboro because I get my hands on little Max.
Wait, hold on. Wait just a damn minute. No way I'm wrestling in this cesspool here in Atlantic City. No shot. Plus, this actually does give me a little idea, though. You want a rematch against me, and the greatest tag team of all time wants a rematch against you. We're in Atlantic City, huh? How about we roll the dice a little bit? I'm sure Tony Khan's gonna love this idea. Hey, Punker, if in the condition you're in, you can beat the greatest tag team of all time, FTR, with any tag partner you're choosing, I'll give you a match against me, any match, anytime, anywhere. However, here's the deal. It can't be Tweedledum or Tweedledipshit over there. They have to head to the back. Good luck finding a partner in the locker room who doesn't hate your guts. Now, in the meantime, Wardlow, if I were you, I'd suit up, because you got a match next. And I'm going to keep the party rolling, because my name is Maxwell Jacob Friedman, and I'm better than the best in the world, and you know it.
Wow, a high-stakes challenge. Thrown down by MJF.
Lot to process there, Excalibur.
Punk can get a rematch with MJF anytime, anywhere, if he can find a partner here tonight and defeat FTR.
He'll find a partner, but I feel bad for him.
The switch around.
Nothing Punk can do is bully him. I was wrong.
Punk, yeah, he kicked off of Cash Wheeler. He's got Harwood up on the shoulders. GTS, no, intercepted. Big rig! The big rig from FTR! Moxley in there and breaks it up.
Oh. A violent breakup by John Moxley. He brought it. Let me tell you, he brought it, that
saved
Moxley.
Yeah, man, that saved it right there.
No one in AEW has been able to survive the big rig. Moxley knows that. and he had a very timely intervention there for CM Punk.
And look at all four men just doing everything they can to get to their feet, all four.
Moxley and Punk standing back to back.
He can't take these clean shots, at least not very many of them.
FTR, Punk and Moxley slugging it out. CM Punk and FTR sent in. Oh, wait. Punk goes through. Oh, put to the midsection. Wait a second. Very nearly saw GTS and Paradigm Shift simultaneously. But FTR, such a high ring IQ, they identified the danger. They were able to escape and now look for the stuffed pile driver.
Good call, man.
Oh, Moxley.
Breaks it up.
Rear naked choke. He's got it on.
He's got the hooks in, and then, whoa, CM Punk floats over, Anaconda Vice by CM Punk.
Tap out, look at the tap in.
The tap out, but Aubrey Edwards, her back is turned. Tully Blanchard.
If your goal is to piss off Punk.
He's achieved the goal, right?
You're doing it.
Tully saw the desperate situation that Cash Wheeler was in, and
Tully fighting to get off those shoulders. He felt himself going up. He had to kick his leg.
Oh! He has that Tully Blanchard!
Let it roll up!
He's got the trunks too! Oh my God!
Did he get it? No.
Near fall.
Oh, that was close.
Good long, fat two count.
Whoa, wait a sec, Punk. He's got a GTS and Paradigm Shift. They hit it. One, two, three!
Moxley
and CM Punk. That's what tag team wrestling, in my eyes, should be about.
He's coming for you, Max.
MJF laid it out earlier. Anytime, anywhere. CM Punk and Jon Moxley victorious.
If you don't know by now, you should. My name is CM Punk, and what I am is straight edge. I'm drug free, I'm alcohol free, and that means I'm better than you. Does that sound familiar? Those words I spoke for the first time over 20 years ago, and they became the foundation of my career. And I can sit here in Nashville, Tennessee, and feel pride that that foundation grew into such a career that I have managed to inspire the next generation of professional wrestling. Some of them are sitting in the locker room right now. Some of them became wrestlers because of me. Some of them became straight edge because of me. Hell, some of them sit like I do. And then there's MJF. He tries to walk like me, to talk like me. He could never think like me. But when he beat me in my hometown, twice, you would think that I would be furious, that I would be mad. But to tell you the truth, Max, I'm proud of you. Where you stray from the path is you fail to retain the knowledge of the lessons that you are being taught. Maxwell Jacob Friedman fancies himself Piper in Portland, Brett in Calgary, and Punk in Chicago, when in reality he's just shitty little Max from shitty little Long Island.
The foundation of Max's career has been a ring that he has used to beat opponent after opponent, and it's a ring that he won with help from other people. So now the situation is this, because of last week, shout out to John Moxley, thanks for the assist. I now get to pick the time, the place, the date, and the match for my rematch with Little Max. So we'll get right to it. The time, probably right after sundown. The place is Orlando, Florida. The date is March 6th. The pay-per-view is called Revolution. Which leaves us with the match. And I started to think about some of my toughest matches. And I thought the situation that I'm in, maybe you put me in a cage. No, but let's be honest. I've seen Wardlow. I'm sure he can climb a cage. And Max can still run. Max can still climb out of a cage and run from the lessons that he so desperately needs to be taught. Piper in Portland. So I go back into the vault and I think of these matches that I've had with legends, matches that were hard. And the cage matches seem like they were easy because, believe it or not, ladies and gentlemen, I've won more cage matches than I've lost. And losing got me thinking of what are the toughest matches I've ever lost. And the ironic thing about losing a tough match is that's when you learn. Those are the lessons that I really retain, because we need Max to learn some lessons. So I thought back on the toughest matches of my career, matches where I've literally left pieces of myself in the ring. And I think, Piper in Portland, Piper in Portland. Max, you want to be tethered to Piper so bad? You're going to have to be tethered to me. And 2 days removed from the Hallmark holiday, Valentine's Day, I'm left without a Valentine. And it's very poetic that I get to ask you the question, Max. Piper had his, now I have mine. Maxwell Jacob Friedman, will you be my Valentine? And I know Max is backstage right now pissing his pants because nobody wants to be in a dog collar match. Sometimes they take years off your life. I promise you they take years off your career, but that's the goal. That's the lesson you need to be taught, Max. So I'm going to ask you to come out here right now because there's one more thing I need to tell you, and I want to look you directly in your eyes when I say it.
Well, this is getting most interesting, gentlemen.
Dog collar may be the single most dangerous match you could ever get involved in. And it takes me back to 1983 of Greg Valentine and Roddy Piper.
I want you to take it all in, Max. And I want to leave you with this. This picture.
Wow.
You see it, Max? I'm sure you remember it well. Possibly the greatest day of your life, and to me, it was Friday. Sunday, March 6th, Orlando, Florida, Revolution pay-per-view is gonna be the worst day of your life, and to me, it's just gonna be Sunday. The price you paid to see me on this day pales in comparison to the price you will pay on March 6th. The canvas I sit on's not gonna be stained with your shitty spray tan. It's gonna be stained with your blood.
Unnerved. Oh, and he's walking out.
We've only had one dog collar match before in AEW history between Cody Rhodes and
Mr. Brody Lee. Yeah.
Absolutely. And now we're going to have another one.
Sunday, March 6th, live on pay-per-view, CM Punk MJF dog collar match.
The aforementioned Mr. Punk,
wow,
making his way to the ring after very emotional words.
I
don't think I've ever heard MJF speak from the heart like that.
Listen, I had five kids. A couple of them had ADD. It's no joke, man. I get it. I can't believe what I just heard.
It's kind of sad.
And bullying is a serious matter, man. This is shocking.
Is it true? Is that real?
They're booing him, but I can't believe I'm saying I feel for him, man.
And Punk is conflicted, but
I used to wake up every morning, splash water on my face, and I'd look at myself in the eyes in the mirror, and I'd ask myself, am I the bad guy? I never really had an answer, and of course, I don't truly believe that everybody thinks that they're the bad guy in their own story. I mean, up until a week ago, I was certain that Max was the bad guy. And I'll say right now, I think what Max did last week, for him to come out here and bare his soul like that on national television, I think that takes courage. And it's courage that, yes, I did not think he had. He spoke about a lot of important things, a lot of deep things. But I also can't shake the feeling that I'm being gaslit. I'll make it very clear to everybody here, and especially everybody at home, I don't think Max is lying. I believe those things happened to him. Where my questions lie is in his sincerity, and I must be getting soft in my old age because I just don't know if it matters. There's a famous picture of me on the internet, very young, with Steve Austin. And after much lesser men framed him as somebody who took his ball and went home, I didn't get mad at the world. I didn't lash out and do horrible things. And since I've been here in AEW, I've seen Max knock out the legendary Dean Malenko, who's suffering from Parkinson's. I've listened to Max bury Brian Pillman Jr.'s father, the late, great Brian Pillman, in his hometown. I had to sit and back and watch Max say awful things about Darby Allin's uncle. Here's the thing, ladies and gentlemen. Here's one fact that I know is hurt people hurt people. When I came here, Max stood in front of me, he introduced himself to me, and he stuck his hand out, and I didn't shake his hand. Now, am I to blame for all these horrible things that Max did? Am I Dr. Frankenstein and he's the monster? Listen, I think everybody has to take responsibility for their own actions. But I don't think right now there's anything else that I can say that's going to be more impactful than something that I can do. And in order to do that, I need Max to come out here, and I don't want anybody but Max from last week to come out here, and we can talk. We can have a conversation in front of the world.
He was having trouble finding his words there, which you really don't hear. I mean, he usually knows what he wants to say. Here we go.
Wait a second. I mean, which MJF are we going to get here?
There's no telling. He's wrestling's version of Symbol, perhaps. Dog collar. Sunday night pay-per-view. Remember that.
So here's the thing, Max. I've done horrible things in my life. I used to be you. So full of hate. But listen, man, I poured alcohol down an alcoholic's throat. I covered a legendary wrestler in the ashes of his dead beloved manager. I mocked a wrestler's addiction until he lost his job because of it. And I'm here to tell you right now that all that hate, it's not just going to keep you warm. It's going to burn you up. I'd like to think that my respect isn't just given, it's earned. And right now, this is bigger than me. This is bigger than you. This is bigger than wrestling. This right here is about that 11-year-old kid who's at home watching right now, and he looks up to you the same way you looked up to me. That's what this is about. And I might be wrong, but I woke up this morning and I splashed water on my face and I looked at myself in the mirror and I asked myself a question. I said, are you the good guy? And I finally had an answer. And that answer is, I sure am trying.
Any dog collar match in the history of wrestling.
Wow. I didn't expect that.
No. Well,
I mean, think about MJF as a young kid looking up to CM Punk, and now finally, this cathartic moment. After all those years of just hatred and disappointment in the heart of MJF.
Oh! Oh, right down the middle. The low blow. Almost feels premeditated. premeditated.
Feels premeditated. He ain't worth a damn.
The scum of the earth.
He's not worth a damn.
And the heat seeker.
Oh, God.
Planted CM Punk. This is absolutely premeditated.
And that proves it right there.
This kid needs some time with Dr. Melfi.
No, this kid needs to get his ass kicked.
But I don't think that's going to happen. He's calling out Wardlow and Sean Spears, and Spears with the dog collar in his hand.
And Wardlow gave him the ring.
A dynamite diamond ring, MJF. Look at the hate in the eyes of MJF.
He wants to take him out before Revolution. He doesn't want that dog collar around his damn neck.
Oh, the dynamite diamond ring.
Right in the head. Right in the head. And down goes Punk.
And Sean Spears just hyping up MJF. As MJF teeing off. And I was, look, FTR coming to ringside to run interference on AEW security.
And the Pinnacle coming together.
And CM Punk.
Punk has been busted open.
Yes, he has.
I mean, a deep laceration on the face of CM Punk at the hands of MJF and that damn ring.
That ring tearing at the flesh of CM Punk and MJF once again, concentrating on that wound.
My God, this kid has gone psychotic.
This is one of the worst things I've ever witnessed since we started AEW.
And it's clear MJF used that personal history to manipulate CM Punk to lull him into a false sense of security.
Threatening our ring crew.
Taking it too far, fellas.
Yeah, they took it
way too far.
You stupid old man. I'm a snake. The greatest trick the devil ever pulled was convincing the world he doesn't exist. And this Sunday at Revolution, I'm gonna show you and all these mindless sheep that I am the devil. Himself!
Few people are gonna understand that being in this much pain makes certain people feel so very alive. I think you understand, Max, and if you don't, on March 6th, you will. You are going to find out exactly what you think you already know, that CM Punk is the master, and I know exactly who the I am. You want to call me PG Punk? You want to pretend like I'm not that same guy? You want that same guy that you grew up idolizing? Congratulations, Maxwell, Jacob, Friedman, but you're not ready. And on March 6th, I'm going to walk you like a dog. I'm going to beat you and beat you. And I'm gonna beat you until your own mother won't recognize you. I'm gonna leave parts of you in that ring, and I'm gonna leave parts of you all over Orlando, Florida. This is what you want. More importantly, this is what you deserve. On March 6th, I will become a monster to fight the monsters of the world. Because I'm CM Punk. And I'm better than you.
Thank you.
Can he say Punk is the best in the world? We're about to find out if that is a conclusive statement.
A little old school here for CM Punk, man. CM Punk showing MJF that Max is not the only one that can play mind games. Punk looking like he has a fire inside.
This is going to be so ugly.
Punk,
so physical.
Harkening back to his roots in Ring of Honor, not just with the music, with the attire, the attitude, everything.
I wonder if MJF truly understands what he has gotten himself into.
When Punk was the underdog, when he was the voice of the voiceless, when he had yet to become a household name, this was his anthem. And he will fight once again.
CM Punk is one of the most intense individuals I've ever met in this business.
Round the right knee. It's the knee. Oh, Shining Wizard. And MJF spills to the outside.
Got hit. MJF got hit right in the face with that chained up leg, that knee, as Excalibur described.
And the blood once again flowing into the eyes of CM Punk. I thought Punk may have been thinking the GTS, but instead he cracked MJF in the face of that Shining Wizard, that leaping knee strike.
You know, I really think the chain inhibits the GTS. I think that it's so difficult to get him up with that chain all wrapped. You could get it wrapped around yourself.
It's true. It could inhibit the mobility.
Yeah.
You know, MJF has been busted open. And he has a dazed and confused look on his face.
Oh, and look, the chain across the eyes of MJF.
And fans are cheering this, man. Look at him standing up behind him cheering.
And Punk delivering right hands to the face of MJF.
Your fans chanting, you deserve it.
I can't think of anybody more deserving of a beating like this than MJF.
He's getting woodshedded all to hell here.
Yeah.
Is MJF.
Come on, kids, get out of the way here, man.
And the right hand's be raining down on the head of MJF. Remember, it's all legal. There's no countouts here in this dog collar match. Dragged around the ring by the neck, Punk on some level has got to be relishing the opportunity to do this to Maxwell Jacob Friedman.
And at some point, the fatigue factor has to be considered here.
Yeah. Oh, no. And the fatigue factor even quicker now. The pace of that is quickened because of the chain.
And the loss of blood not doing either man any favors.
Punk. Once again, the chain. Oh.
Just measuring him, man. Just absolutely measuring him with that chain.
Retribution is hell sometimes, fellas.
Punk once again wrapping the chain around the knee, maybe thinking another shiny one. Oh!
Man, that did that knee no favors.
Yeah, you know, guys, I hate to say it, but I saw that coming. He was just there, and you could see that, man, you're taking a little bit too much time with that steps behind him. I just saw that coming. God almighty.
But that's got to be the fatigue setting in.
Yeah, you're right.
In a very major way.
Well, that mercy affect your timing. You know, you're a step off or two.
Give Max credit. He knew where he was. He had great awareness. He knew the steps were behind him. He knew just to roll out of the way on that.
Nobody can say that the MJF is a dummy.
Oh.
He may be controversial and disliked, but he's not a dummy.
Oh, listen to that.
You hear that chain in the flesh? MJF's eyes were in a different position than they were just a few moments ago.
I know, bugging out of his head right now.
Yeah.
CM Punk maybe down a bucket of blood, but MJF soon to be close behind.
alternate checking on MJF.
Punk's taped hands are both, that tape is just soaked with his own blood. And now Punk says, okay, it's time for somebody to go nighty-night.
The GTS, but that knee, you see Punk hopping on one foot.
That's from that shot he took to the steps and the chain wrapped around his leg.
Can Punk even get MJF up, let alone deliver the GTS? He's trying to fight through the pain, but oh, Punk collapses.
Yeah. Got to go another route. That's not going to get it. Punk can barely stand. So then it makes you wonder, what the hell's Punk going to do? And what is MJF going to do to finally put this thing away?
MJF.
Anybody's ball game here, fellas.
Yeah, look, I mean, look at how MJF is just so dazed.
Yeah.
You can see it on his body language, Tony.
Yeah, you can see it. And not only that, the fans are trying to get behind him, trying to rev him up, if you will. And Max just, out of desperation, goes right back to that knee.
Yeah, he wrapped the chain around his fist, too.
And as we mentioned, MJF right-hand dominant. Chain, and this is where the chain is so difficult. It got wrapped around the ropes. But MJF breaking at the wound on the face of CM Punk.
The chain does no favors.
MJF struggling with the chain, but now he's got Punk on the apron.
He got it unwrapped, and this is bad news for CM Punk.
Oh my, if he hits a tombstone onto the floor.
CM Punk,
come on.
He was holding on that middle rope.
Oh, but see, MJF couldn't hang on to the waist, it allowed
his right hand.
Punk to counter! But the tombstone pile driver, Punk using his own injured knee to deliver that attack.
Your good call, because he's not able to follow up with anything at all now.
Here's another look at it.
It hurt Punk more than it hurt Max.
Punk's right knee now has become extremely problematic. Obviously.
Look at the concern on the fans' face.
High drama here in Orlando. AEW Revolution. We thank you for joining us wherever you are and watching pay-per-view.
Undoubtedly the biggest night of action here in all Elite Wrestling. So much blood has been spilled by these two men. The referee had to get a fresh set of gloves on. I don't think I've ever seen that before.
No.
Well, it's a war of attrition. Somebody's got to. It can't go much longer, in my opinion, just simply because of the blood loss.
I can only think that Max is playing possum here again, guys.
You just don't trust him at all.
No, I don't. I just see. Look at that.
Wrapping the chain, maybe thinking of delivering that huge elbow drop.
High risk. Will it be high reward?
He shouted, best in the world, but MJF once again dodging out of the way.
Because of the attrition that you're talking about, JR, it took a long time for
him
to
put that.
Oh, to deliver that elbow drop, and Max saw it coming. Didn't have to do much, but just roll out of the way.
Yeah, like we said earlier, Max is no dummy. He may be a miserable person to many, but he is no dummy.
And MJF right now, I mean, he may be conserving his energy for explosive bursts like that, like we saw at the steps, and then once again, dodging the elbow drop.
I'm also impressed with MJF's toughness.
Who's he got here? Listen, anytime there's a bag, I think we've
Not a yam bag.
No, I think we've seen enough wrestling to know what's in that bag.
And it won't Max, be marshmallow.
And Max apparently, because he knew where it was earlier in the day, took that bag and put it under the ring.
A premeditated assault by MJF.
He knew exactly where to go.
My God.
Oh! Rising knee strike this time from MJF.
Look at him. He's telling the fans he's going to put him to sleep. Going to put Punk to sleep.
Oh, wait. He's looking for the running bulldog.
Face first on the tax.
But he's biting the hand, the thumb.
Not the hand that feeds him. The hand that beats him. Not going to beat him tonight.
But MJF, the kick to the top of the knee, the injured knee of CM Punk.
Oh!
With the right hand
on the edge of a cliff there.
Can't imagine. Just cannot imagine.
And Punk sliding. He's already got some of those tacks in his boots. That's going to be difficult for his footing.
Uh-oh.
Here we go. Do it.
Oh, the Punk was looking for the brainbuster, but instead.
The knee got him. His right knee gave out. Couldn't hold that vertical base to execute the brainbuster.
A glance from behind to measure him.
Oh, Punk kicks his legs. Lands on his feet. Swing and a miss by CM Punk. MJF, notice he's throwing elbow strikes, not punches.
Smart. You got a broken hand, no forearms.
MJF charging in once again. High roundhouse kick. Did you see the tacks fly up off the boot of CM Punk?
I tell you, this game plan of Punk paying off here. MJF not able to use the right hand.
But remember, it was MJF that brought the tacks in the ring.
But they've not come into play, and CM Punk's...
Not yet, anyway.
Well, CM Punk's done a good job of staying away from those tacks.
Oh. We saw CM Punk pull this out in Chicago. He could be thinking Pepsi plunge.
Fans start to hear that hush, that murmur of anticipation.
Look at MJF fight out violently.
MJF knew it was coming. He's felt it once before. He didn't want to have it again, especially on the thumbtacks.
Look at the face of this menace.
Somebody's got to gain an advantage here, and they both seem hell-bent into driving the other into the thumbtacks.
The thumbtacks already on the bottom. Oh. No!
Superplex into the thumbtacks!
My God! Pain that must be.
Just a few on the back, but most of them hit right on the rear end, the lower back.
Look at the replay. MJF suplexing CM Punk, and attack cover. Whoa!
Great opportunity there for MJF to end it, but it didn't go his way. And somehow Punk is blocking out the pain long enough to at least stay coherent in his game plan.
Paul Turner was counting the pinfall. Even he's not safe from the thumbtacks. Got some in the palm of his hand. Both men walking in a proverbial minefield here.
Dog collar.
Oh.
They just rolled over on the tacks.
And the cover, one, two, oh.
Boy, that was not a kick out. That was a left shoulder off the canvas. That's about all CM Punk could muster. It's amazing he could do that.
Yeah, the dog collar has come unhooked from the neck of MJF.
Well, how in the hell did that happen?
Wardlow! Wardlow!
Wardlow?
Wardlow, we saw.
He's already won the Face of the Revolution ladder match.
MJF is calling for backup.
And here comes Wardlow.
And Paul Turner just relinked the chain, importantly, on the neck of MJF. But that may not matter because MJF calling on his backup.
Wardlow with a rather strange look on his face.
He's calling for the ring.
Well, the best man didn't bring the ring.
He can't find it.
Oh, Punk. He just brought MJF in. BTS!
Oh! Right into the tacks. Right into those tacks.
And Wardlow locking eyes with CM Punk.
Wait a minute. It was in the right pocket. Oh, okay.
Yes, it was, Tony. Yes, it was.
Well, he came down to put it in the ring. You might as well put, there you go.
That weapon, Chris does a ring.
Listen to the cheer of the fans.
Fans love it. They love what Wardlow has finally done, and that is to tell MJF to essentially kiss his ass.
It doesn't matter what finger it's on. Put it on there, buddy.
The Dynamite Diamond Ring.
on the right hand of CM Punk, who, by the way, is also an orthodox striker.
All that time, MJF was lying in those tacks.
Punk with a firm grip on the dog collar.
Oh, boy. MJF spit right in the face of CM Punk.
To the very end, buddy.
Oh, and Punk tees off at the ring.
The cover. It's over. Mercifully, this bloody brawl has concluded.
CM Punk.
Catharsis comes in many forms, but what better way than beating MJF bloody?
Yet we say that Wardlow gave a ringing endorsement in this match. And it was to CM Punk. Hell yeah.
Never, ever bet against CM Punk in any environment. He finds a way to win.
Especially in a dog collar match. Look at Wardlow. Doing the right thing here tonight.
And MJF wasn't even aware that, boom, Punk got the ring. That Wardlow had laid the ring in the ring. A lot of rings there.
The right hand of doom from CM Punk.
He's going to be aware when he looks in the mirror and the imprint of that diamond ring is going to be in his forehead.
Dr. Sanson in the ring to check on both these gladiators.
That's a good call, JR. Gladiators is right. I got to give both of them credit for this.
Two tough guys, folks.
Oh, he's not done, man.
Whoa.
Get out of his way, buddy.
CM Punk invoking Bruiser Brody here tonight.
A dear old friend, the late Bruiser Brody. What a dandy.